All right, I'd like to welcome everybody to the second episode of Drunken Disorderly. I'm Miller99Zulu. Once again, this is the show where nothing's really planned and everything's made up. We've got Dismount over there. He's on the Samsung VR. This is the first time he's ever used it. We know it's kind of old and been out for a while, but he's going to do some Face Your Fears with us here.
Cannot wait for this.
Yes. So... Sorry, we had a week off. I was in Detroit for work, and these two couldn't manage to get together and do the show, so that's just the way it goes.
Why is there a whole section full of porn on here?
Well, you know.
Nothing wrong with a little porn.
Well, it's wrong whenever it's donkey porn. I got a thing for that.
True.
So, hope everybody's had a good couple weeks. How about you there, turd?
What?
How's your couple weeks been, man?
It's been all right. I spent some time with the boy, and... worked a lot.
Whatever, you got a girlfriend again, so you don't play video games anymore.
Never on video games. He always makes the excuse that I had to work late hours, and by work late hours he means my girlfriend said no and I want to go have candlelit dinners with elves.
What about you, Dismount?
It was pretty good. Actually today me and my daughter, we went to Fort Wayne, went and ate some Chinese buffet, which was not that great. But we topped it off with some Starbucks from the mall, so...
Yeah, I saw the picture that used the Snapchat filter on you, homo.
Well, that was her. She's like, Dad, we gotta take a Snapchat.
I blame it on my daughter, too.
I mean...
Yeah. So, repping my Blackhawks. We're on a roll. Got a shutout last night. So.
Heck yeah.
Go Hawks.
These guys are douchebags and act like they like hockey, so... all right, so what we're going to do is we're going to get Dismount here going on Face Your Fears. What's your screen say for you right there?
There's a whole lobby here of shit.
All right, you're going to go to the one that says Face Your Fears.
Face Your Fears right in the middle.
Yep, touch the side.
Touch the side.
Mm-hmm. In the middle of the side. Did it work?
Yep. All
right, you're going to go to the door to the right.
It's black right now, and it's loading.
Yeah, you're used to that.
It's got the Unreal Engine.
Yeah, it's legit. It's actually powered by Oculus, man.
I want to go to the door to the right?
Yeah.
All the way to the right?
Not hard right.
Okay, so the one to the right.
I haven't bought any of them yet. I'm being a cheap ass.
Okay, so I'm going to go here.
Yep, and then pick a story. You see the three stories there?
It's black right now. Okay, there's three stories.
Yeah, pick one of the stories there.
Fun with Jingle, The Ghost, and Light as a Feather. I'm going to go with The Ghost. I like ghosts. So I just... There we go.
Okay, now you've got some things going on the screen now?
No, it's black.
Is your sound working?
Oh, I'm in bed.
Is your sound working?
Yeah, it's working.
Okay.
It's pretty quiet, though.
What's going on?
Okay, right here on the side.
I'm in a bed.
Pardon me, guys.
Okay. There we go. It's all the way up now.
Okay. Me and...
Listening at high volumes for too long. Whoa.
Me and Turd have done this before. That's why we've got Dismount on the goggles.
First time ever. Breaking
There's a lamp. Oh, my God. This shit looks so fucking real.
Yeah, you're a tool. Once again, we know this is old stuff, but he's never done it. I did it for the first time tonight because possibly one.
Oh my God! There's a fucking kid right there. What? No. Oh my fucking God!
And honestly, this dude is not overreacting. This is the way he reacts to anything.
I love scary movies, but I will scream like a little bitch every time I watch a scary movie that's really scary.
And it also helps that he's got about, I don't know, a quarter of Yeg in him.
Ish. Oh, he's over there behind the bed.
So this is kind of carrying on with our scary video game topic we had. We had a friend of ours, Joseph Hole 66, talk about the suffering.
Oh, he's behind the bed. Oh, his fucking eyes are glowing. Oh my God. Oh my God.
we were talking about the suffering, and he said that he loved that game. I love the game as well.
Yes. Yeah, you were the one that turned me on to it.
Yeah. So did you ever play the suffering too?
I didn't.
Just as good.
Oh, my God. The door's opening.
I did send you guys a link this week on Facebook to a new...
Yeah, what was it called?
Something about Asylum.
I saw that. That's definitely a game I'm probably going to pick up.
Oh, my God! Oh, where the fuck did he go? Where did he go? Where did he go? He's gone.
So, yeah. If you guys have any comments, if you are watching, don't forget we do have the live chat up. So, we'll answer any questions, get you in the conversation.
Yes, comment.
So.
Questions. Make fun of them.
Yes. How's it going, Dismount?
Oh my God, there he is! It's going great. He's climbing on the fucking wall right now.
We're probably going to have him, since we tend to talk about the video games early, we're going to have him probably do all three of them.
Just in the background, kind of.
Yeah, he's just going to be hanging out while I try to keep a conversation
with that's kind of cool.
Douchebag over here. He's like talking to a tree.
Not always.
So.
No, not always.
You been gaming at all this week? I mean, it kind of sucks for me for...
Right, yeah. No, I did a little Battlefield 1.
That's about all you. That's all we play.
And some Paragon.
No, I don't play that. Did I tell you what I had to do?
No.
I had to format my PlayStation because it quit playing movies.
Why are you up there? Oh, my God! Oh, it came so close to me.
Is he on the bookshelf?
He just went in the air vent.
Yeah, he was on the bookshelf.
Yep.
The book at you. But, yeah, I had to reformat my PlayStation because it wouldn't play movies.
How does that happen?
I don't know. My wife did it. So she's probably watching, so she's going to yell at me.
Well, that happens.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Oh, my God! What the fuck are you doing?
You all right over there, Dismount?
It looks like he's looking at me.
I know.
Creepy.
I almost hit Sarah in the face looking.
Oh, he's gone. So. Oh, the doors are moving. Oh, my God! What the Oh my God!
This is an reaction. No, keep it on, man. Keep it on, because it's gonna go back.
It's back to the story.
Yeah, pick fun with jingles.
Fun with jingles.
Yeah, this one kind of freaked me out.
Ah, I like that.
That one. Oh my God, that was fucking insane. I love this thing.
So what's your first? Because you had the same opinion of the VR when. Dude, quit looking at me, man. It's weird. When the VR came out, you had the same opinion I had. Oh, it's on a cell phone. It's going to be dumb.
Yeah, this is actually, with it being on a cell phone, oh my God. with it being on a cell, like this, it feels like this was a sole thing that's running through your computer, but it's on a cell phone with just a headset, basically.
Yeah, you've got literally the headphones that came with the Samsung in there.
I mean, as I move, as I do anything, it moves like it would be a normal VR
your story
thing.
Playing?
Yeah, okay. The clown doll just fell off the bookshelf on the floor.
Fucking hate clowns.
I fucking hate clowns too.
So, any other?
Oh, there's a ball that just went underneath the bed and disappeared.
I guess we shouldn't have put this one on the Oculus because he's kind of the diehard video game nerd over here.
Right.
So the video game section's kind of...
Did you have a chance to see anything, any new games or anything like that?
Not with my new job. I worked till...
What'd you have to do in Detroit?
We went and partied at a casino.
Wait, so the ball's over there, the clown's in the bathroom.
My work paid for it. Fed us free drinks. It was a good time. The soundboard... Dismount, you turn the title screen on.
Huh?
Yeah, there we go.
Sorry.
He freaked out and hit the button that turned the intro on, so sorry about that, technical difficulties.
I saw the photos of your date.
Yeah, did you see our prom picture?
Yes, I did. It was fantastic.
Me and Big Stuart.
With the, what is he, like
6'2",
something like that?
300-pound muscle.
A cool 300.
Yeah. Built... hulking massive a man.
I like how it does the sound too.
Yeah. Just in case you've lived in a cave, obviously Trump won and now it is 60 degrees in Indiana, so that's a good indication that they know.
rising?
Yeah, the you know. So.
You never know. He may do good.
Like I said, I mean, you saw my Facebook post. I'm not against him. I'm not for him. He just scares the shit out of me because he's got a sharp tongue.
He does.
Andy believes that he should date his daughter, which is a little weird.
That is.
Isn't that right, Dismount?
Weird. What? Oh my God.
What do you got going on over there?
Well, there's a clown over in front of the closet doors now. Oh my God, it just got sucked into the closet by hand and now the closet doors are moving.
Oh shit.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Ooh.
Is that one over
here? Oh my God, no way!
I don't think so.
Oh, the doors are open. Oh, the doors are open. Oh, the doors... Oh my God, what the fuck?
Oh my... Look how red he got.
Oh!
Oh
my God!
All All right, we'll get him off the VR before he has a heart attack.
He's
sweating. You can't see this right now, but he is honestly sweating.
Literally sweating.
I'm sorry if I yelled in your ears in the podcast, but that scared the ever-living fuck out of me. Oh my God, that is amazing.
But yeah, that is the Samsung VR.
Oh,
fantastic.
Got a GS7 in there. A recent acquisition. I know it's old school, old stuff now, old news, whatever, but it was our first time playing with it, and
it was good though. I liked it.
Yeah, we love it.
So basically you have to have a Samsung phone and the headset that they have with that, and it becomes VR.
Yeah, powered by Oculus. It's actually an Oculus app.
Okay.
It's not like the Google Cardboard or whatever.
No, it's a good piece of technology. I thoroughly enjoyed it when I tried it.
Yeah, he told me about it, and it kind of blew him off. And then a mutual friend of ours had some, and he's like, hey, why don't you – do you know anybody that wants one? And I was like, well, let me check it out. And I'm sold on it. So, Dismount, you're a video game guy. So what's
new in the world?
So I keep on a lot of video game stuff. One of the things I saw with the For Honor game we were talking about last episode.
Yeah.
They have another closed beta happening this coming weekend.
Yeah, but you gotta get invited to it, don't you?
All you gotta do is go to their website.
What's the website?
It's forhonorgame.com, I believe. You can go on Google, type it in, For Honor game. Go on and sign up. I signed up and I got picked. So, like,
are they picking everybody, you think?
I think so.
I'll sign up for it.
The way it kind of seems...
Vikings suck. Stuart, that was for you.
The way it kind of seems is that they're just wanting to get as many people, especially with this new one coming up, is that they're wanting to get as many people involved in as they can to... Ubisoft is usually pretty decent about stress testing their servers.
Oh, but why did the Rainbow Six Siege servers suck so much?
That is an infrastructure problem, not so much a stress test problem.
Yeah, but they did the same thing with that, and it's still...
Well, they did, but people could get on. You can get on and play against other people.
You can't play with your friends.
The matchmaking was horrible. The everything else was just terrible with that, but...
Speaking of which, the second season's coming out for that.
It is. The second season was announced a few weeks ago.
Yeah, are you going to get it? I haven't played the game since Nom.
See, that's the thing. I haven't played it for a while just because they've made a bunch of really good updates to the game as far as like hit detection and stuff like that, which was a big complaint for everybody. And they have done a lot to try and balance stuff out, but I don't feel like they're there. I feel like they're... It's like trying to adjust the brightness on a camera.
That's why we're 3 minutes late.
They go from one extreme to the other extreme, and they're trying to find that happy medium. They're trying to, but it's a testing game, which should have been done during the beta phase, which is why they need more people to play the beta.
People?
Yeah, people. People. That's why they need more people to play the beta, because that's how it's going to go down.
Goddamn
hillbilly. But next weekend, closed beta, go to the website, sign up for it. It's going to be awesome. I played the first closed beta they had. It was awesome.
You're welcome, Ubisoft.
Yep.
You just gained 6 more signups.
Yep, at least. And so I think it's going to be pretty good. I like it. I think.
You watch any movies?
I have not watched any movies lately.
I watched that new Harry Potter movie.
The
Fantastic Beasts.
Yeah.
It was actually kind of cool.
Was it?
I didn't go to the theater. I mean, as you guys know, I'm a giant pirate. Not Butt or Patch.
Got her.
So, what was that beep?
I don't know.
Oh, hey, I know what that was.
That was a Facebook message.
Stuart's having trouble commenting.
You gotta sign in to YouTube there, Stuart. You have a sign in. We got somebody. Yeah, we got the... Look at his angry face. poo.
I think it was.
It was chocolate ice cream.
It is.
But,
anyway, Siege.
Siege.
Okay, we totally just destroyed that. hit the button.
Hit the button?
Hit the button. Hey, Levon.
What?
Douche. Yeah, Levon's our resident douche. As you can tell by the hair.
Don't knock on my hair, my hard part. Okay?
Dude, that's some hardcore fuckboy hair.
That is.
My son's got the same haircut. He's fucking handsome.
So anyhow, Hitman, the full collection of all the seasons or all the episodes of Hitman are all coming together in one collection at the end of this month.
Like the original games? Or?
No. This is, so they've done this new Hitman thing, right? And they've done it like...
Keep going, but I got a Hitman story for you from the original.
They have, they're doing it like the, like Telltale Games, where they have episodes. Mm-hmm.
Kind of like and, the Walking Dead series?
Yeah, it's everybody's doing this whole microtransaction thing. So let's put out an episode and an episode and an episode. We're going to charge $10 for this one, $10 for this one. Well, now they finally, at the end of this month, they're done releasing the episodes of Hitman, and now they're going to release all the episodes together as one collection for $60. And it comes out, I think, January 31st, I believe. So
you get it?
See, I love Hitman. I love the Hitman games, and it's stealth action. It's not a shooter per se. It's not a stealth game per se. It's
when I play it.
It's a
thing is I'm like super tactical, like in the heat of the battle.
Right.
But when it comes to like, let's sneak over there. I'm like, I like. Have to get in this major gunfight where I'm outnumbered. Right. But anyway, when you're talking about Hitman, you played the first one?
I played, I did not play the first one. I played,
hit the button. That makes you a...
Yeah, he's got to douche. That over.
Yeah. Anyway, you didn't play the first one?
I didn't play the first one. I played, I believe it was the second one on PS2.
Oh, see, I played the first one on the PC, and there's a part in one of the very first missions where you have to kill this grocery delivery driver, and he goes to take a pee. And granted, this was, when did the first one come out? Can you Google that? Granted, this was, the graphics were good for the time, but they weren't spectacular. They were almost borderline N64 type graphics.
Mm-hmm.
So he goes to take a pee. And I had a sniper rifle because, of course, I got all the cheat codes for it. And,
right.
And put them in, and I had the sniper rifle. So I was watching him pee because I was going to shoot him, and they actually gave him a tabernacle. He had an N64 wiener. I'm serious. He had
A
floppy hang down while he peed. I bet you could probably Google image it, and it would probably give you... Well, be careful. But he did. He had a hang down.
The release date was 19 November of 2000.
Yeah, so
17 years ago.
Shut up. Dang. How old were you then?
2000, I would have been 16.
Levon was like 9.
I was in middle school, for sure.
9-ish. Well, if you guys are having any problems... commenting, and you know us on Facebook, send us a message and let us know. We don't have the stream. You pulling the stream up?
Yeah.
I get it up right here.
So just let us know if there's any problems. We had some problems the first one, and we would love to get you guys involved in the conversation.
Yeah, we're gonna actually, my plan is for like the last part of the segment to do like a Q&A. So if anybody wants to comment and ask questions or whatever, we're going to do that. So
it seems like I'm doing all the talking here. What do you guys got like?
That's because you're a motor mouth and you talk a lot.
You guys are shy.
That's touche. Speaking of video games, the new Ghost Recon Wildlands coming out. Release date still, as of right now, March 7th. I read a thing the other day that said that it was going to be... it got pushed back to July, which is really going to fucking irritate the shit out of me.
Yeah, I hope not.
If they do that...
I will be okay with that if it makes the game better.
Yeah, but we can't have
They pushed back Rainbow Six how many times, and it still came out shit.
Siege?
They pushed back...
The Division.
The Division
got pushed back 2 years.
See, I'm worried the new one's going to be Division, where it's just grinding XP and you...
Here's the thing. I watched a video today. It's a new 20-minute video of the single player.
This is Clint's thing. I watched a video.
I
I watched a video.
Yeah.
I watched it, and they
turn it on so we can see it.
I'm working on it.
Sarah,
I just got a request, Clint, from Sarah.
Mm-hmm.
She wants you to do Light as a Feather on the Oculus. We'll get to that.
We'll do that at the end of the stream. It's okay. Yeah, the live chat's still the same. Okay. So I watched this video today.
I bet you that's Sarah and Stuart watching us right now. Can't you guys comment?
I watched a new video. It's a new 20-minute video of the Ghost Recon, and they were showing the single player aspect of it. Like, and it seems to me like it's going to be like Ghost Recon Future Soldier for PS3, mixed with
where you can teleport. No, that was Ghost Recon.
That was another Tom Clancy game. Yeah. It wasn't Ghost Recon. It was like Battlefield 2 for Xbox. And it seems like it's going to be the best of both worlds from Ghost Recon Future Soldier and what The Division wanted to be. So,
thank you.
It showed going, it's an open world game, and it showed them going from, you know, like the section that they were in, going to a new territory that they'd never been to. And the way it looked from the mini map that they pulled up was like every section has a boss. It's got an ultimate goal for each section, but how you get to that boss and defeat that boss depends on your actions in the game.
Stuart's about ready to go nuts. It's still not letting him comment. So that means nobody can probably comment.
So it was.
We got three people watching.
It was really good.
Is that you? No, don't watch it. They're giving us false numbers. We need to try to figure that comment thing out. Stuart, just hit us up on the messaging here, and I'll read your comments out live.
Throw a little test in there.
So
go back to the YouTube feed. Sorry, guys. We're still working on this. We're rooks. So yeah, Levon just
came through.
The turd did message. It's because he's got balls in his mouth.
Smash that like button.
God. Yeah, both of you.
Like a teenage prom date.
Thank you.
But yeah, it looks really good. I heard that it was getting pushed back, and seeing this video today really makes me feel like it. Because I talked to the guy at GameStop today when I was up at the mall. And I was like, hey, I was like, so I heard Ghost Recon got pushed back. And he's like, I haven't heard that. Let me check it out. So he goes on the computer and checks it out. And he's like, according to our release date, it's still scheduled for March 7th. He's like, they're usually pretty good about keeping up about it. He's like, but if you've heard something recently, he's like, it may be like a day or two before it updates in our computer system. Well, I'd read like a week or two ago that it was getting pushed back to July. So I feel pretty confident in the whole March release date. But, and then seeing that video today, it was like, oh my God, this is going to be, should be pretty good. So they're supposed to have an open beta for Ghost Recon and it says sometimes in the near future.
And they also said WMDs were real.
Artificial sweeteners were safe. WMDs were in Iraq. And then Nicole married for love.
Things aren't always what they seem.
Are they? Are they?
Fuck boy.
I got a question. GameStop or Best Buy? Because you're a Best Buy guy.
Yeah.
You always go to Best Buy.
Well, it's because I got the Gamers Club and I get 20% off new games.
So,
which Gamers Club is worth it, I do have to say.
It is worth it.
But, I mean, it's just like any other trade-in program. Like, you trade your car and you get raped, so everybody hates GameStop for it.
Well, here's my thing with GameStop, and I've read this from, and this is...
Oh, here we go.
This was from
Fanboy
Publishers, and this was from, you know, people that made the games and stuff. And their reasoning behind doing it with GameStop was because... And it's the same thing with anything. It doesn't matter if it's a car, if it's a game, if it's whatever. But a publisher makes this game, okay? And they sell it for $60, and that's to recuperate their cost for making the game. And at a certain point, they're just making profit, right? Which, American dream. Make America Great Again.
God, I'm going to vomit everything.
You know, but...
Dude, you hate Trump, too.
Grab my pussy.
But...
Why are you looking at me?
Right by the... What are you doing?
But... Okay, so I go to GameStop. I play a game. I play a game, and I'm done with it. I go trade it into GameStop, okay?
You get 75 cents?
I get 75 cents for that game that I paid $60 for, and they're going to turn around and sell it for $49.
Mm-hmm. To me, because I won't buy it new.
Right. Right. The publisher doesn't get any of that money.
Mumbly?
The publisher doesn't active... If it's... Let's just use Call of Duty as an example.
Oh, God.
So Call of Duty sells Call of Duty... Black Ops 3, worst game ever. And
you get Tourette's.
Bless you.
I buy it for $60.
Which you did.
And then I turn around and give... I'm like, fuck this game. I give it to GameStop a month later. They're going to give me $20 for it. $29. They're going to give me $30 for it, and they're going to turn around and sell it for... Instead of $59.99, they're going to sell it for $54.99. Yes. And the guy's looking at the shelf going... I could save $5 if I buy this copy. I've never had Call of Duty Black Ops before. So he's going to buy that copy. Activision doesn't get any of that money.
So? You know what they get? That's one person to buy the map packs, to buy the season pass.
Here's my thing about that. This is why the microtransaction and the season passes and the DLC has become so popular is because of places like GameStop.
Yeah, so it helped them out in the long run.
Because they sold this game, I buy the game for $54.99, and then I'd got to turn and buy the DLC. So just because Activision didn't get that money for the used copy...
Can we see comments? Sorry.
Just because Activision didn't get the money for that used copy... They are now getting the money for the DLC. And that is why we're paying for DLC.
Stuart, are you trying to comment on Facebook or on YouTube? Yeah. Here's what Stuart said. Me no understand this technology, not letting me comment. Stupid phone not giving me anywhere to leave comment. Light shade of green at the moment. He's not quite full Hulk yet.
Not quite.
He'll be on the show sometime so you understand why we talk. Every time we talk to him, we sound like a Neanderthal.
Yeah.
He probably couldn't stand straight up in this room.
So is he watching the stream right now?
Yeah, he's watching it.
If he goes down, if he's watching it on his phone, down at the bottom, there's a bar that says,
here we go.
Look. Chat.
You got it. Down here at the bottom. It's just a big white blur right now.
Yes. Swipe up the live chat.
Douchebag.
Pardon me.
Queeners.
Oh, wiener. Down here at the bottom says live chat. You swipe it up. And then you type in there.
And then you comment.
And you say, wieners.
Wieners.
So, yeah.
Oh. I didn't even see that over there. Your notepad. I wasn't even paying attention.
Yeah, see? I already had the show all planned out, and you didn't even know it.
Speaking of which, I was producer... going to ask you guys about that. Who's stoked for Assassin's Creed movie?
I am.
Okay, the Assassin's Creed movie is no longer playing in theaters. I'm just telling you because we were gonna go watch it today. Me and Alyssa were gonna go watch it today in theaters, and I couldn't find it anywhere.
Well, it's because you only place you go to movies is the stupid dinner theater. No,
I went to Fandango where it shows every play time of
isn't
every
that
movie.
The wrestler?
Not Fandango. It's Fandango.com. They show. You put in, it's movie wrestlers. You put in your zip code and it shows you every movie theater in your area and what the show times are. Okay. So I went there. The only theater in the general area playing Assassin's Creed was the Dollar Theater in Fort Wayne.
I wonder if it tanked.
And I don't. I did. Everything sounded good. But it's been.
The story, though.
But it's been out for so. It's been out since December. It came out in like the beginning of December.
Good point.
So the and that movie theater plays
Sarah at home. Second, check to see if there's a good copy of it. Sorry.
That movie theater plays second run movies basically, and they charge cheaper admission prices, but it's a shitty theater. Like we went there one time, and like the best part of the movie was watching people run into the railing going down to the seats. It was a horrible quality movie. The audio was horrible.
You know, so his mouth opens. Sorry.
and it was just not good. But
just happens. You put a dick shaped thing in my face and open my mouth.
Video game movies. Resident Evil 7 is coming out.
The movie or the game?
The game is coming out at the end of this month.
Yeah, the movies.
The new Resident Evil movie, and it's gonna be on VR. Which I'm kind of excited for now, since I played the...
You don't have... Are you going to get the PlayStation VR now? Joseph Hull said it wasn't that...
I'm thinking about getting the Oculus Rift on PC and getting it for PC.
But, once again, we get back into the fact that your PC, even after you do what you say you're going to do, is still going to be...
It's all... I've done research onto this. It's all about your graphics card.
Oh, yeah.
And there's...
What do you got in there now?
Right now I have an AMD or an ATI. Well, I guess it's AMD now because they bought out ATI, but it's a 7770. And it was okay.
It was okay
3-4 years ago.
That I'm not buying ATI.
I used to argue with this fucktard over here and this.
We'll get into that later in this episode because
graphics cards. I'm going NVIDIA.
We'll get into that later. But going with the whole NVIDIA thing. Everything I've researched is that the NVIDIA 1070 and the NVIDIA T80.
Hey, twits. I've been trying to scroll up and scroll down with my phone side to side, shaking around like a sumbitch. The little people in there know like me. I'm touching live stream. I'm flipping around. It's annoying. It's a mother. Give it to Austin. He'll figure it out, Stuart.
Figure it out, big dumb.
So the NVIDIA 1070 and the NVIDIA 1080... are both 4K ready. They are both 4K capable, and they're both VR ready. So what I'm thinking about doing is getting the NVIDIA 1070 or the 1080 and just putting it on my computer, because the AMD proc that I have is compatible with both, because it's a fucking 6-core processor. And
it's an AMD.
Yeah, the thing is AMD, this is... This is tech shit for later on in the episode. Anyhow.
You know we don't follow up.
Okay, here's unscripted people. Really. Here's the thing. Okay, Intel and NVIDIA, side by side.
Still relative to video games.
Intel has made architecture to where their processors work. If it's a 4-core, if it's a 6-core. If it's a 4-core, 6-core, or an 8-core, they work in cohesion with each other.
And they work all the time.
Right. If you do an AMD, the way their architecture worked was that if you have an 8-core, the first core runs until it can't run no more, and then hey, second core, I need your help. And so then the second core kicks in, and then it's like, second core's like, I'm too overloaded. And it's like, hey, third core, I need your help. And then the other three cores aren't doing shit. They're just sitting there like, smoke break.
So AMD's so, like a union processor?
Basically. So with the new architecture and with the new chips that they have coming out, the Ryzen that they just announced at CES.
They're finally getting on Intel's level.
The Ryzen AMD chipset is going to rival, if not be better than Intel.
Yeah, but you know what it's going to do, just like any other AMD? Going to overheat?
No, the problem with the overheating with the AMD, I've done my research on this again. The problem with the overheating was that it wasn't even a video. I actually read. I sat down and took 30 minutes to read three paragraphs, but I read it. And the reason that they have the overheating problem is because of the core issue, where they have where just one core is just fucking maxing out, and then it goes to the second core, and then it goes to the third core. Whereas Intel uses each core equally, so the processor is not doing as much work because each core is doing equal amount of work. With this new Ryzen technology that they have, it's going to alleviate that.
Everybody saw it. Sorry.
It's going to alleviate that and make it to where they're not going to have those issues they had in the past.
That's like saying, what's one of the most dependable handguns ever made? Like what's
Beretta.
Okay. And then you're going to get...
A Glock.
Yeah. And Glock's finally copied Beretta.
They finally caught up.
Copied.
Right. They didn't copy, they caught up.
They copied it. they conquered it.
Which the Army chose their new handgun.
Hey.
They did.
SIG. They went SIG.
SIG Sauer is going to be the new Army handgun.
Yep.
little fun fact, side note there.
Yeah, once again, we're so scripted. But I still, you can't sell me an AMD and you can't sell me an ATI.
Oh.
Yeah, no, I learned.
You argued with me forever about it, and you did too.
I've never
but
argued.
You said you're going to go with NVIDIA.
I've never argued. My whole thing is I'm a cheap ass. AMD and ATI has always been cheaper than Intel and NVIDIA. There's a reason. It's just like some things. Okay, if I go and buy nacho chips and I buy the Doritos or I buy the Walmart brand, it's going to taste the same.
No.
It's going to taste the same. No. It does.
No.
Some things are equal. Doesn't matter if it's got a brand name or not. What you're paying for is the brand name.
Well, a lot
in electronics, you get what you pay for.
I tell everybody that. I mean, I've told you that. Me and my wife argue about it all the time.
When I built this PC that I'm on right now, I built it because I could build an $800 gaming PC.
See, now any hardcore gaming nerd that may come across this and watch it is gonna flame you.
Oh, I'm gonna be hung, and I'm gonna be hung from the yardarm.
From the yardarm.
Do they still hang people from the yardarm?
I don't believe so.
I don't think they hang. He doesn't think that they still hang people from the yardarm.
Okay, I'm missing this one. I'm missing this one.
It's A Few Good Men.
Oh, okay.
He's like, I'm gonna hang your client from the yardarm. He's like, they still hang people from the yardarm? I don't think so. He don't think they still hang people from the yardarm. But it's the age old battle. AMD's always been behind. They've always been, except for when DirectX 12 came out. And all the hardcore PC magazines and everything admitted because NVIDIA was still focused on DirectX 11. Well, when DirectX 12 was announced that they were going to have the architecture, AMD was still in the middle of their DirectX 11 shit.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, well, this new shit's coming out. So why are we even focused on this? Because they were so far behind on DirectX 11 that they stopped and they just started focusing on DirectX 12. And so for the first 6 months of DirectX 12 being out, AMD was ahead of NVIDIA. Of course, that got surpassed by NVIDIA like pretty quick. NVIDIA.
Crossover?
Yeah. Actually,
right now, according to FutureMark, the AMD Radeon Plus Duo is rating higher.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Like, this new architecture that they've brought out with AMD.
Well, it's actually tied with the Titan X, which is amazing.
That's what I'm saying. This new architecture they came out with at CES at the beginning of this month has been, it's crossing boundaries. It's getting up there with Intel. It's going to rival Intel. It's going to rival NVIDIA because...
Until they change something.
Well, and it is. Once DirectX 13 comes out, then who's going to be ahead? Because basically AMD is putting all their eggs in a basket for DirectX 12. And once the new architecture comes out, who's to say who's going to be ahead? But this new shit that they're coming out with, it's going to be good. I think it's going to be good. And the thing is that Intel and NVIDIA have been so much higher priced than AMD because they've been so far advanced that they can charge whatever they want to. If AMD becomes competitive with Intel and NVIDIA, then the price wars start instead of the tech wars. And that's what I want to see. I want to see consumers, you and me, I want to see them benefit from the struggle. This is capitalism at its best. Hey, I came up with this new thing. Well, hey, I also have this same thing.
Capitalism in China.
If he comes out with this and says, hey, I have this new thing, and me, you don't have it, he's like $900, and we're like, oh, ours are $300. And you're like, oh, fuck, $300. But it's not as good as his. If mine and yours are as good as his, he's like $900, and we're like $800. He's like, $750 and you're $650. It's like an auctioneer, but in the opposite direction, because everybody wants to make their money back from what they've spent.
I understand capitalism.
And that's why I think the AMD catching up with Intel and NVIDIA is going to be a good thing.
So how long is it going to last?
That's the question.
Because Intel hasn't released. I mean, they've just different generations.
I'm not even going to speculate, because they have announced nothing. AMD has announced this. Intel is basically building on what they already have.
Well, I mean, it's been
the i7. You know, they've got this new architecture out for it. I think it's called Cody Lake is the new architecture for
Ben Stiller. I mean, yeah, not Ben Stiller, but
Ben Stiller. It's been Intel has been the main leader in computer,
as Stuart would say, so he understands.
They are the Ford of computers.
They're the Ford F-15000.
Yeah. Now that we got sidetracked on the computers and stuff,
that was a super long rant.
Yeah. What the heck is Split M Night Shyamalan?
M Night Shyamalan.
New. We got completely sidetracked from the whole movie section of our podcast. This new movie, Split. Have you guys seen the previews for this?
No, I haven't. Okay. Preview for Logan.
I want to see that movie. One? Yeah. With the little girl.
I heard it was amazing though.
Do you haven't seen the preview for it?
I haven't had a chance to watch it yet.
Oh my god, dude. Okay, so Logan, the Wolverine, is old.
Yeah, I know.
Because remember the last movie, he took away his powers, right? Yeah. Well, this movie, he's old. He's gray. He's got gray hair. He's got the little girl. There's a new preview out.
The little girl is, right?
No. Well, it's supposed to be She-Wolverine.
She-Wolverine? Oh my god.
Whatever.
There he is.
Hey.
Respect that Ford.
Hey, Stuart, tell Clint who She-Wolverine is, please.
So it's basically the new one. The new trailer shows her in this gas station, and she's like taking this stuff. And there's like this guy. She's like sitting there drinking a pop and eating some candy. He's like, "Hey, you got to pay for that."
X-23.
And she grabs him, throws him down, and you see Logan come over, and he's like, "That's not appropriate," and like grabs her and pulls her out of the gas station. Like, it's going to be really good. Basically, he's handing off the torch to her, and he's trying to make her into a good person. Because right now she has all these powers and she doesn't know what to do with them. So it's going to be a good movie, I think so.
That's how you're going to end that?
So what's Split?
Split. So Split is this movie. It's got from the
Berserker Claw.
The X-Men, the original or like the origin movies where Professor X is younger.
Have you seen this, Stuart?
It's got that guy that plays Professor or plays Xavier.
McAvoy.
Yeah, it's got him. He plays in this movie, and he has split personalities, and he abducts and kidnaps these three girls.
Oh yes, I did. I saw this in the theater when I seen
that's better.
Seen. Cool. All right. So when I went and seen Suicide Squad. Yeah, I saw the preview for it. Yeah, it looks fucking fantastic.
It's an M. Night Shyamalan movie.
Shyamalan Ding Dong?
Shyamalan Ding Dong.
It's Clint's kind of movie because it's about abducting girls.
Only if she's my sister.
We already talked about that. Do we really want to talk about that on there?
Maybe later.
We were going to name the podcast.
So
politics and with a hint of incest.
So he goes and he like jumps in these cars with these girls and like sprays them with this shit, and they're in this like basement of his house, and like you see these two people, but all you see is their feet like talking back and forth.
Their feet talking?
You see their feet underneath the door, and then he opens the door. And, like, you hear this girl and this guy, and he's like, "I'm going to keep him." And this girl's like, no, you can't do that. And anyhow, the door opens, and it's this guy, and he's bald, and he's standing there, and he's like, "I'm sorry, he has issues right now. You're going to be okay."
And like then, his whole his physical features actually changed, didn't they?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so like it's not just his personality, it's his physical features.
Yeah, and it's an M. Night Shyamalan movie. Yeah. So it's going to be weird.
Pretty cool.
It's going to be like it seems to me like it's going to be like a multiple personality, but where the multiple personalities actually change the physical character of the person.
I can't believe I'm here with you two homos.
It's going to be a good movie. Like it's a thriller. It's going to be a mind bender.
Who you are anymore?
Did you not watch The Village?
No.
No.
I don't even know why I'm doing this
village,
podcast.
Yes, is the village the one with the foggy woods around it? And if you go out the woods, you die. There's a werewolf or something.
No. There's like special creatures out there that like kill you, and then they find out at the end of the movie. Spoiler alert! That the creatures that are out there in the woods are actually the people of the village that are trying to keep them. They're pissed.
Do you still have the porn from the rabbits?
We did find the picture, by the way.
Oh, I did.
We did find the picture. It was in the box.
It's still in the box in the same hiding spot that it was in before.
You put it back?
I did.
That's so weird. Do you, like, worry there's going to be a ghost?
Well, no. Yeah, I am.
Where's my porn?
Dude, there's been some weird shit happening at this house. You don't even know.
You're jerking.
Yeah, I hear pages peeling in.
Clint's going to be like, where's all my jerkins?
It's like just regular Vaseline. No fucking be getting all. Don't go getting all. Don't church it up. Okay, it's now still dirty.
Yeah, but would a ghost need Jergens, or would they just use its own ectoplasm?
Well, not all ghosts have ectoplasm.
That's fair.
Did you watch the new Ghostbusters, by the way?
I did.
I hated it.
You say you hated it?
It wasn't
funny.
I hated it.
It wasn't funny at all.
No, the funniest person
was...
The one SNL chick was kind of funny, but... Thor. He was the funniest part of
that. I didn't think he was funny.
Who? Thought he was funny. The guy that plays Thor.
No such thing as ghosts.
Yeah.
Stuart. Hey, you need to... Stuart, you need to keep the other one of these. It's freaking amazing.
I'll buy it off you.
I thought it was okay. I thought it was good.
Clint would buy it if he didn't have an iPhone like a homo.
Clint, I will buy it off you.
I'm about to go get a Samsung now just so I can get this shit because that shit was fucking scary as shit. And I love it.
You, by the way, don't forget, we got to do light as a feather with you.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Not where he's going to lay down. We're going to light as a feather, stiff as a board.
Right. What movie was that? That was The Craft?
No, little teenage girls do that at slumber parties, don't they, Alyssa?
Was it The Craft? It was
The Craft.
Yeah, okay, no. It was in a movie, too.
It was in a movie.
Hated it. What did you hate?
Hated
it. Oh, you tried it? Your simple brain couldn't work it?
Split. It's going to be a good movie. I think so.
What is your guys' favorite movies of all time?
It's
a dumb question.
You got one.
I get one movie I have to watch for the rest of my life?
One movie. If you can never watch any movie ever, you get one movie. Watch your one movie.
You put me on the spot.
What's yours? You brought up the question.
Yeah.
Fuck you guys. A Few Good Men. Love that fucking movie. Tom Cruise, classic, great movie.
But
yeah, you can't handle
Stuart. What would you pick?
You can't handle the question. Truth. No, you guys can't handle the question. I can handle the truth.
We're talking to Stuart because he's the only confirmed viewer right at the moment.
What did you hate?
He hated the Oculus thing. That.
Oh, that's because he's...
muscles. Too light.
Probably couldn't carry it over his head.
If they had a weightlifting video, I'd watch it.
You got a huge gourd.
I would have to say the third Friday the 13th. I'd probably watch that.
Really?
Okay. I can see that.
I know, but...
Classic horror. Classic horror, I like it.
Oh, yeah.
It's a classic horror movie.
Because, and the reason why, because that's the movie where he first puts on the goalie mask.
Fair.
Second one, he wears that stupid pillowcase with an eye hole.
Yeah.
Predator? Yeah. Yours would be Predator, Stuart?
Predator.
Good choice.
Predator's a good one.
Because you know why?
The original Predator, though?
Yeah. You know why he picks the original Predator?
Because it's got Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Arnold Schwarzenegger's in it. Jesse the Body Ventura is in it. Dutch can't handle the truth. Okay. He hasn't come up with one yet.
I know, it's hard, though. It's really hard.
Pony,
have to go
Barney, with... Power Rangers. Ooh, didn't you used to be a huge Power Rangers fan?
Yeah, the one with Ooze.
The movie?
I took you guys to see that.
Yeah.
Speaking of Power Rangers.
New one's coming out.
No interest.
There's a new trailer out for it now.
I saw it. Yeah. No interest.
Really?
No. I don't like to touch little boys' peepees.
I watched the original TV series and this new Power Rangers movie.
That's because our age difference.
Yeah. What, 3 years?
You're like 32.
And you're...
36.
3 years.
Your math is horrible.
It is. It's horrible. 4 years. Okay. So, no, the new Power Rangers trailer.
I really thought it was 3 years.
Shut up.
You're so dumb.
Muscles and...
Drinking and video games.
Kids don't drink.
Yeah, it makes you dumb.
No, I thought the really good...
Or have fuckboy hair. Dude, how do you have fuckboy hair and a unibrow?
I don't have a unibrow. I just got really big bushy eyebrows.
No, I thought
the unibrow line.
I thought the new trailer for the Power Rangers movie was really good, and I watched the original Power Rangers movie. I watched the original Power Rangers TV show.
I did too.
Past, I watched, what was it, the one after that where they had, like, the dragon was the Red Ranger, and...
Yeah.
And
what is your movie, anyway? No, we're talking about gay Power Rangers.
He said, he said Power Rangers,
go.
I thought.
Let's go.
Look.
Yeah, like, everything was, right, yeah. Yeah!
Yeah.
I'd have to say Braveheart.
Ugh. Ah, it's a good movie. What?
Braveheart.
Good movie, but...
It's 3 hours. Like, how...
I know.
If you watched an hour of it each night... You'd be good.
Your life's only going to last 3 nights.
Well, no, I'm just saying. If you can only watch one movie forever, you watch an hour of it one night.
Pink Ranger, yes.
An hour of it second night.
Kelly.
Hour of third night. And then the fourth night, you watch the first hour again.
No, because...
It was a good movie.
Hey, Blackhawks, your voice is on echo. Clint's picking me up. Picking me up in your mic there. Because I'm getting loud. I'll just keep it low.
I'll
bring it down here.
Dabba dabba low girl. Dabba dabba low girl. No? Okay. Braveheart. Braveheart was a good movie.
Yeah,
like Braveheart is a good movie, yes. But it's not.
It's either that or Ghostbusters.
I'd say I'm surprised you didn't say that because you are gay.
No. How is that
gay? Do you like the movie Stripes?
Yeah.
Have you seen it?
Yeah.
Okay. What about you?
I've watched bits and pieces of it. I've never watched the whole thing.
With the tactical RV. Yeah. Is that better, Stuart? Is my voice done echoing?
You sound okay.
Yeah. New XXX movie coming
out.
No.
Gay. No.
Gay.
You can't kill Xander Cage, put Ice Cube in there, and then bring Xander Cage back.
Here's my thing. You
can't make another XXX.
Here's my thing with XXX movies. With Vin Diesel movies. Okay. Vin Diesel has become about the money ever since he's been an actor.
Thank you.
Look at the first Fast and Furious movie. Then he
Did
had.
You say he's a good actor?
No. I said he's been about the money.
Okay.
He had the first Fast and Furious movie, and it was a good movie. Then he had Fast and Furious 2, Fast 2. Wasn't in it. Fast 3. Nobody was in it. Fast and then 2. Fast 4, Vin Diesel's back in it. Okay.
Well,
so Vin Diesel,
he had the cameo in the end of Tokyo.
What about the pacifier?
Because he was coming into Fast 4. So you had him in the first one. He's like, not doing a sequel. So they had, what was the guy?
The Rock?
No. And
Tyrese.
Two.
Tyrese.
Oh, Tyrese, yeah.
Tyrese Gibson.
We home.
Triple X.
King Arthur.
He made
King Arthur?
The new one, I want to see.
Oh,
that one.
King Arthur's. The one with
May, I believe.
The guy from Highlander.
I'm sorry, you lost me.
Doug Glatt?
No, Doug Glatt. Highlander, the movie.
Highlanders?
The TV series. You had that
King
guy.
King Arthur versus William Wallace. Who wins and why?
Ooh.
Ooh. That's a good one. That's a good one for later.
No, he put it out there.
He's going to put it out there? King Arthur versus William Wallace. I want to say King Arthur.
Why?
Why? Because
what's King Arthur fighting for?
His kingdom.
Okay. William Wallace has already been there.
No, William Wallace never had a kingdom. He was fighting for freedom.
William Wallace is fighting for love.
He's already fought somebody fighting for their kingdom.
William Wallace was fighting for somebody that was fighting for their kingdom.
One-on-one, who wins? They were not saying armies. This is one-on-one.
King Arthur.
Why?
William Wallace was a master with the sword.
King Arthur was gifted Excalibur.
Gifted.
Okay. Because of his extreme talent. Nobody just pulls Excalibur from the stone. You have to be...
It's coming.
You have to be... You have to be chosen to pull Excalibur from the stone. Excalibur's not going to choose you if you're a weak-ass punk that can't beat fucking William Wallace.
William Wallace is a weak-ass punk?
No.
William Wallace would turn you...
I'm saying, he's not... Excalibur is not going... The sword is not going to choose you if you can't defend your kingdom against any adversary ever. But, when was King Arthur ever defeated? Name one story where King Arthur was ever defeated in battle.
Well, let me ask you this. Where does this take place?
It doesn't matter. King Arthur...
Yes, it does, because...
Well, name one battle that King Arthur...
William Wallace is a real person.
He is. And King Arthur is fictitious.
Is it taking place in fiction, or is it taking place in the real world?
It's taking place...
Their question asker.
It's taking place in a joint universe.
You can't do that.
You can.
No, you can't. Yeah. You can't triple stamp and double stamp.
You can't...
You can't triple stamp
and
double stamp.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
Yes, you can.
God,
on air, YouTube.
when we're in town, I can't do it.
What's up, Melon?
So, no, King Arthur, you can't. Excalibur's not going to pick somebody who can't beat
Melon.
Anybody.
Who wins, King Arthur or William Wallace? We're not going to wait for you, but
yeah,
Stuart, who do you have?
Think about it, though. William Wallace, what happened to him?
It's 2 a.m. in the UK. Awesome.
2 a.m.
What happens to William Wallace?
He gets betrayed and gutted.
He gets beheaded. What happens to King Arthur?
He gets drawn and quartered, by the way.
What happens to King Arthur?
He's fictitious.
He becomes king and never gets defeated.
Never? Then why isn't he still king?
Because he died at some point in time.
Well, I thought Excalibur was magical.
It is. It doesn't keep people from the dead.
Dr. Dre wins. This is true.
Yeah, that's true.
Dropping them beats. I cannot argue with that.
Yes, car guys.
Do you like cars? Yes, absolutely. Actually, two of us work in the auto industry. Fuckboy haircuts, just gay.
I'm a carpenter.
Douche. Yep, there we go. What about you, Melon? What's since you live in the UK, what is...
What's a UK car? What's your dream car,
Melon? Well, that's dumb.
No.
That's a horrible question.
No, it's not a horrible question. Why is it a horrible question?
What is the most common car in the UK? Because I have no idea.
Fiat.
You know this for sure?
It's Chrysler product. They're
all
over the world.
What cars do you have? He has an Audi RS4.
See? Audi.
You, Audi?
Audi.
Yeah, we don't have any fast cars or anything cool like that.
Nope.
Because I have kids. And yep. They take all my money.
You got a Ford Focus.
I drive a Linux Ram. this stream gonna be fun.
I drive a Ford.
What do you drive? What do you drive? I don't even know what you drive.
An Explorer.
You got an Explorer?
Yeah, okay. Ford Explorer.
Melon, where in the UK are you from? Huh?
Back to my whole topic.
Yeah, go back to...
Triple X movies. Or the Triple X movie, Vin Diesel. Okay, so he doesn't do sequels unless he realizes that the movie franchise...
I can talk about cars. We'll talk about whatever you want, man.
So, he doesn't do sequels unless he realizes they're going to make money. Because you watch the Fast and Furious movies, first one he was in it, second one he's like, nah. Third one he's like, nah, till the end of it. He's like, okay, this movie's going to make money. I'll do a cameo to get into the fourth one.
He did get beat.
Ah, Stuart.
Who did he get beat by, Stuart? I want to know this. I want to know who he got beat by.
I don't care what you say, though. A typical car in the UK is a hatchback like a Fiat or a shitty little cheap
See,
car.
I told you, Fiat.
Good call. Melon, you're not supposed to back him up. Guinevere beat him with her cha-cha.
No.
I like to...
Guinevere tamed him with that cha-cha. She did not beat him. But so Vin Diesel does these movies, and he's like, I don't want to do sequels until I realize they're going to make money. Just like Triple X, it was like, Triple X. And then it was like, the second one, he's like, I'm not going to be in that. So they had to get new people. Well, then he's like, okay, this one made money. I'm going to get in the next one. So now they're making a third one. just like the Fast and the Furious movies. And now they have this new Fate of the Furious. And I kind of agree with this.
Fate of the Furious?
It's the name of the new movie. Vin Diesel turns into a bad guy in the movie.
Does he? Put these on.
According to all the trailers, Vin Diesel is bad. He's going against all the rest of the guys on the Fast and Furious team. So,
all right, man.
Yeah.
Who's you have to work in 4 hours? What do you do for a living, Melon? You guys can keep talking. We don't have to wait for his answer.
Mm. So, I don't know. Vin Diesel to me is kind of a...
Yeah. Is it static or is it good?
Static.
Good?
Can you see what's going on? Yeah. Keep talking,
Clint. So, new thing. I've been doing some research on some tech. Razer.
Razer, like...
Like the add-on company with like the mice and the keyboards. They have a new laptop coming out that they're making.
Keep talking.
And the new the new laptop is a 3-screen laptop.
Yeah.
So you open it up. It's got 2 screens that come out from behind it, and it turns into a 3-screen laptop.
Yeah.
It's going to be cool. The keyboard's all chroma. The screens are all chroma, so you have the different color variations of everything. It's going to be pretty cool. They also have this new project that they're coming out with.
I see you. No! Do it.
They have this new project coming out. It's I can't remember what the name of the project is, but it's basically a 4K projector.
Yeah.
And what it does is you have your screen.
That's the
conductors,
by the way.
It has a screen. Okay, then you put this projector in front of your desktop, and what it does is it projects the rest of what would be the normal it would be like, so if you were like to do a 3-screen thing, this one does it to your whole wall, and what it does is the projector actually reads. Okay, so you have a speaker here. You got the wall caves in over here, and it does this. What it does is it actually adjusts the pixels and everything to your surroundings, so it makes it flat.
Hey, Stuart just told us. You got to remember the stream's behind on us, on our comments.
Yeah.
Stuart just said that the third Triple X does have Ice Cube in it, so now
does.
I'm a fan. Doesn't he? Does he die in it?
I don't. It hasn't said anything, but it's got Vin Diesel and Triple X, and Ice Cube.
I don't know.
But the new thing and what they're planning on doing,
Amazon deliveries. That's awesome.
Is including the whole chroma thing with everything to where your surroundings with the projector light up like they would with chroma. So you got this going on, and then you also have like the side, and let's say like you're getting hit. So, like, the walls on the side of the room start turning red because you're getting shot.
Oh, that's cool.
It looks really awesome. It's going to be pretty cool. It's in concept design right now. But they did show a video at CES of it actually working. And basically, you have, like, this screen.
Do you think it'll be expensive, though?
It didn't have a price because, again, it's in concept. So, like, you have this screen, and then I have a projector up here. So what it does is it makes the walls around it the rest of the screen, but it'll block out the part that you can't see. It uses like how your eyes perceive depth, and it will make it to where the rest of the screen is out there.
Right. Melon, my Razer mouse I got wasn't too bad.
Well, it's going to be at first just like everything is. I mean, when 4K TVs came out, they were like, what, $4,000, $3,000, $2,000?
Now you can get them for
$500. It's just like any new tech. It's going to be expensive at first.
Creatives for losers.
And it's going to be... it's going to evolve. Tech's going to become cheaper. Everything's going to become cheaper. More people are going to start doing it. Samsung.
I'm 36. He's 32. And he's
27.
27. That's why he's got fuckboy hair.
So.
You didn't hit the button.
It's going to be good.
Douche button.
There we go. So. We do have a special request for Clint to do some more Oculus.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yes.
It was via Facebook message.
Okay.
So they want you to do Light as a Feather. I've never done Light as a Feather.
You haven't?
No.
So Clint's going to be putting the Samsung VR back on. Once again, we do know it's old. 17, nearly 18. Awesome. Those are good times.
I remember when I turned 18.
You were in the Army, didn't you?
I did. I signed up right after my 18th birthday.
Did you really?
I did.
As you're taking a shot of Jaeger and almost burning your Jaeger and Monster.
I have
Stuart, did we lose you with our nerd talk?
Probably fell asleep.
Yeah.
Like he always does when we're on PlayStation, you fall asleep and you hear him snore. You hear the big old lug over there snore.
You hear no strings on me. So once you're done with your cigarette, we're gonna close out the show.
One more thing I want to put out,
before
we close out, is the with tech shit. They have a new Bluetooth 5 coming out, and 2-in-1 laptops.
How are you reading all this?
Because I do my research because I'm the producer.
You should have just sent us a message. Hey, we're going to talk about this.
So well, I plan on you guys being here an hour before the stream starts so we could all talk about this.
Never really. Producer's man there never really put forth the...
Anyhow,
these guys are old as shit.
Well, somebody said they were going to be here at 7.
What?
Stuart, you're my age. So, shut it.
No, this new Bluetooth 5.
You know one thing that
has
happened today?
What? Ball tag.
We have not bagged turds.
So, this new Bluetooth 5 is going to be... Right now they have 4...
Thank you, Melon. Did you see what Melon said?
Yeah, your prison is fucked. I never disagreed with you. At no point in time have I ever disagreed with you. I just said... He's been president for an afternoon. Let's sit back and see what happens.
And did I disagree with you on that?
You did not.
But I also said his way of thinking is
I'm just saying
as shit.
I'm just saying my whole thing is what president have we ever had that we're not like, this guy's going to fuck shit up.
No, this
look at Obama. When Obama first came in, everybody's like, this dude's going to fuck shit up.
Everybody
when
said
Bush came in.
N-word.
When Bush came in.
That's true. There was riots where they actually hung.
When George W. came in, he said, this guy's talking military and he's never been in the military. This guy's going to fuck shit up. Bill Clinton came in.
He just fucked bitches.
He's a Democrat. He's going to fuck shit
that's
up.
That's all you can say because you love Bill Clinton.
I love fucking now. Bill Clinton. I'm a Democrat. I'm a progressive Democrat. I told you guys this the other day. I am...
Benjamin Martin versus William Wallace. You forget who Benjamin Martin was. Patriot.
I know who he is.
I still got... You guys got me an Excalibur.
You can't... Honest. But, okay, that's like comparing World War I Nazis versus World War II Nazis.
But you can compare it.
Benjamin Martin had firearms. William Wallace didn't.
So?
Okay, so Benjamin Martin's going to win. That's the evolution of combat.
But
you create back in the day you had swords, and then somebody's like, if I take this piece of wood and make a string on it,
Melon, even though we're Mexico because the wall.
Mexican word of the day is hide.
I saw that.
Well, somebody reads Facebook.
I do. Okay, so back in the day you had swords, and somebody said, if I take this piece of wood and put the string on it, I can shoot something at somebody and not be in close range.
Unless it's 7 days a day.
So then everybody's like, if I take a bunch of metal into loops and make it into this cover, it will stop those projectiles from piercing me. If I make this into
evolution.
A faster...
Okay, well, you're getting away from the question.
No, I'm answering the question.
No, it's...
Benjamin Martin's going to win.
But in the movie, Benjamin Martin goes to hand-to-hand with swords and his cool axe.
Yeah. After he runs out of fucking bullets.
We're putting it in that scenario.
More specifically, hand-to-hand combat.
Hand-to-hand combat with the two? I'm going to say Benjamin Martin again.
Why?
Because he had fucking amazing skills with an axe.
Yes, but...
They were both fueled by rage and love.
Okay. William Wallace was using a broadsword, a long sword, which takes longer to swing.
But he was a master with it.
But it still takes longer to swing.
He also He could also throw a rock like a motherfucker.
Let's go. He could fall. Let's go with DPS for you game nerds. Look at damage per second.
Oh God.
Okay.
Damage per second is not.
He's got faster ability with his axe.
But what about damage per strike?
Well, damage per strike.
Per
strike, it doesn't matter.
Okay, gamer nerd.
If he does...
You have a scorpion, I have an intervention. I can get you before you can ever get me. You know what I'm talking about?
Unless we're at distance.
The broadsword's going to hold him at distance.
If I'm using the intervention, I'm going to get you a distance. But it's not the same, because my distance is greater than if I was using an intervention.
Stuart,
or less.
Wasn't the broadsword the length of like two men? In that movie?
Broadsword was like one.
In the movie.
It was one.
Was it one man?
Answer the fucking question.
You still haven't... He did. He said
the height?
He Benjamin
he
Martin.
Did. He's, yeah.
Was it?
He
yeah,
answered.
Thank you.
I said Benjamin Martin. I answered the question a long time ago.
I think you're wrong.
I got to go with William Wallace.
William Wallace was from a different time where... that's what they did.
That fucking in-your-face, hand-to-hand combat, guerrilla warfare. That's what they did. That's what they specialized in.
Hand-to-hand, no fire.
And William Wallace...
Like you said...
Went Hulk. Guns are out.
Majority
hand-to-hand. Hand-to-hand. Benjamin Martin.
Either way,
Hulk.
Gibson loses.
Hulk? What are you talking about?
Do you remember the first time he went on a fucking hatchet spree? He saw red and just fucking...
He went up against a bunch of homos like this guy. Yeah, you know who I'm talking about, Half-Stash.
Don't hate on the Half-Stash.
He went Hulk.
Against a bunch of redcoats.
Who were out in the woods not
no
doing
offense,
red
Melon.
Coat tactics?
Oh, yeah.
Melon.
No offense, Melon.
No, seriously, though. They had horrible tactics.
They did. But at that point in time, when he went out and fought them, they didn't have those tactics. It was hand-to-hand.
The Patriot is Benjamin Martin, and if you watch Braveheart,
William Wallace. Yeah. Actually,
the Patriot...
Right.
From Scotland.
Is Benjamin Martin. He was a... He was a father.
Tomahawk. Sorry, they weren't axe.
Who went rogue during the Revolutionary War?
He actually didn't go rogue until he still took Minutemen out with him. Not Minutemen, but
they were.
He went rogue.
Militia.
Yeah.
Did you say hero rogue?
No, he went rogue.
He did not go rogue.
The only reason that he he didn't join the revolution. He had no desire to fight in
then
the revolution.
Then why did he have his
His whole thing was peace for everybody. He had redcoats and
why? What did you say? Because we were talking about redcoats being pussies.
Redcoats are the British. He had redcoats and the 13 colonies people at his house, and he was treating them both.
But what you're missing
it
is
wasn't until the
what
red
was
coat
rank? He had a rank.
No, he didn't have. He was.
He did. He was previously
in the service.
Yeah, he fought previously. If you remember, he fought.
Well, yeah, he was.
So he was for the
British Army.
He
before America decided to secede from Britain. Before America decided to secede from Britain, he was in the British Army.
I don't think he was.
He was.
He didn't have an accent.
Well, no, he was American. It's a movie.
All the other Brits had accents.
Because they were from Britain.
The only cool one is in the middle.
Right. That's fucking right.
He doesn't know you. you know why he thinks you're cool? Because Melon's a Muslim, and he thinks you're Muslim.
Anyhow.
I know I was wrong, Stuart. Shut up.
The only reason he didn't have a British accent was because he was
Mel Gibson
American.
I thought he fought in the Revolutionary War.
He did. That was the Revolutionary War, but he was on the American side.
No, he wouldn't, Stuart. You're dumb.
I gotta disagree, Stuart.
No, Benjamin, you gotta shut the fuck up.
Darth Vader
would
kill them both.
Okay, who'd win in a fight? Darth Vader. See,
who would win both? Riggs.
Martin Riggs.
Lethal Weapon.
He's cool because of his haircut.
Appreciate you, son.
All right, so.
Yeah, we got to get you on the feathers.
We got to close out here.
We're going to close out with some.
We're already running
over a little bit. Again. But it's all in good fun. It's a podcast, so we're allowed to do that.
So, once again.
Let's say I'll edit it down to be an hour.
No, just keep it. That's the beauty of podcasts. You can have a 2-hour podcast if you'd like.
Well, I edited it down to an hour on the last one, so.
What'd you cut out? The porn section?
All the porn.
Nope.
Okay, this is really fucking me up.
Hey, plug in those ears for
him. I'm gonna get poked in the face by the fucking drone, aren't I? Meh. Okay, how do I turn this thing on?
Okay. It should be on already. It should detect your face.
It's not. It's black.
Story of your life. What's it doing?
It's black.
Pop up?
Nope. I already don't like this technology.
Pop up?
Nope.
This one, right?
I want you to get off my dick, man.
Get up off my dick. Everybody know that big dick, baby.
Let me see it.
Oh, that's Pikachu right there.
That's Onion Turtle.
Oh, I heard something go boop.
A spliff?
A spliff.
What the dick is a spliff?
That's a weed term.
Is it a weed term?
It is.
Stuart, what do you think of Levon's hair?
Oh, shit.
Broke now. Everybody knows that broke dick
same. I have my mic off. It's not good.
You've had your mic off?
Mm.
You can't play the Oculus and smoke.
I know.
Because it's on.
I heard it go, womp.
There we go.
Is it working?
Yeah. Just go to the menu.
The producer is not that smart.
Eat a dick. Okay. So I'm going to face your fears again.
Yeah, go to face your fears, door on the right, and do feathers.
It's loading. Loading. Want to go to the right?
Yeah, the second door on the right.
First door on the right?
Second door.
Just first wind. Door. Okay, so I'm going to go.
I'll do it.
Why is a feather?
Oh, I can't see it.
That puts a lot out.
Oh, it's dying.
Uh-oh.
Beep, beep, beep.
Anyway, that is the Inductrix FPV.
That's pretty neat. I like that.
I told you this one to get.
I got a PTO. I might pee my pants.
Where'd you get that? Hobby shop, or you get them on Amazon, whatever. $99 ready to fly comes with this gay video game controller.
And you have it. Oh, wait, no. You were using that. Sorry.
I'm using that.
You were using that.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, what the fuck is going on?
What do you got? What do you
All see? The drawers are open and the doors open. The closet doors open.
Melon, if you fly to the U.S., you are welcome to join us, guys.
Absolutely.
Yeah, for sure.
We will pick you up from the airport and bring you here.
Fort Wayne International Airport.
I will put you
in
the extra room if you fly to the U.S.
And we don't hate Muslims.
Oh.
And we don't hate Muslims.
Oh, my God. Shit's fucking opening everywhere. Is there a way to turn the volume up on this?
Yep, gotcha.
Yeah. There we go.
We would love to have you as a guest on our show, Melon. We're trying to get the Adam Stewart character on here.
Yes, we would like to get Stewart on here one of these weeks.
Except he'd take up the whole screen.
He would. Honestly, where would he sit?
On your lap.
I ain't putting that big ass.
Did you like that
on.
Video I posted?
Which one?
The song. I sit on you.
The thrumic pus for thrust.
Oh, yeah, I gotcha.
Yeah. Oh, God. The dude looked like a freaking Chester Mr. Belding.
What's going on over there, Dismount?
Fan spinning and the.
Booking your flight.
Jack in the box is fucking turning. Oh, shit's moving. Oh, shit's moving.
Message us on
the
Disorderly Facebook page.
Oh, this is going to fuck me up. Oh.
He's not going to sleep tonight.
What do you see?
Everything, all the blocks, like the little box. Oh, my God. All the blocks are on the... Oh, shit's moving. The blocks are spinning around.
They're looking at us.
Yeah, it would be...
Why am I paying for your flight?
One of the Blackhawks jersey.
Oh, the ball's moving. Oh, my God!
I'll let you try it before I leave.
The closet door's open. The bathroom door's open. Everything's freaking out.
Oh, this is so funny. Not knowing what to... I wish I could see what he was seeing.
Came earlier, we probably could have got it to sync up, but getting here a half hour before we start. Yeah.
Oh, they're scissors. Oh, the scissors.
Oh, he's the one on the left.
Everything just dropped.
I'm going to have a heart attack.
Everything just dropped.
Thank you.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, my God! Oh, there's a giant jack-in-the-box right in front of me right now.
Right.
And it's moving. It's turning. I don't want to see it open. I don't want to see it open.
You know he's got his eyes closed.
No, he doesn't. He likes being scared enough to keep it open. The suspense is killing me.
It's just noises. Nothing's happening.
The wind and all that stuff.
That it?
I don't know. It's just noises.
What, just noises? What else is going on?
Oh, my God! Oh, my God. Oh, my fucking God.
he said you look high.
It was just noises. I looked up, and I looked back, and all of a sudden, the little boy from the rest of the thing jumps out of the jack-in-the-box.
On the bed.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, that was
right, guys. Well, we're going to end Dismount's heart attack. That's going to be our sign-off. So, this show, a little less... organized. This is our first one, hard to believe, and our first one was all off the cuff.
It was.
Right.
They'll get better. This is only our second episode. We're still working on it. If you have any suggestions, don't be afraid to comment. We're not going to cry or anything.
Yeah, go ahead and comment. If you guys want to comment on the video, let us know what you guys want to see in the next video. Let us know if there's anything you guys want us to talk about.
Melon wants to talk us talk about cars.
Yeah,
we'll have cars.
Yeah, I mean,
we can do cars next time. So, thanks everybody for watching.
With one of the right some help.
Well, thanks for stopping by.
Tipsy Tanker production.
Tipsy Tanker. All right. Well, we'll see you guys later.
Guys, thanks for watching. Have a good week.
Later.